shepherds hear the angels. In our hearts, may we also journey to Bethlehem and see the child in a manger. But first, we pray for this church and for those we are called to serve. We ask for hearts of goodwill in our families and among our neighbors, in our communities and among nations, that we might truly have peace on earth. Amen.
Thank you. sacrifice your only son, the Lord makes this solemn promise. Your descendants will outnumber the stars in the heavens and the grains of sand upon the shore, and through you and your children, all nations of the earth will be blessed.
Thank you. Come now, Lord.
highly regarded by God, and he is with you. As Mary thought about the meaning of this, the angel continued, Do not be afraid, Mary. God has chosen you to become a mother. You will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus. He will rise to power and be called the Son of the Highest. God will give him David's throne, and he will rule his people forever. Mary asked the angel, How can this be? How can I have a child? I'm a virgin. And the angel said, This will happen by the power of the Lord. His spirit will be upon you, for this child will be the Son of God himself. At this, Mary said, I am willing to serve God as he sees fit. Let it be as you have said. Then the angel Gabriel left.
Thank you.
traveled from Nazareth to Bethlehem. The city was overflowing with visitors, and lodging was scarce. While they were there, Mary gave birth to her first child, a son. And because the only room available to them was a stable, his cradle was a manger, which was a feeding crib for the animals.
Shepherds tended their sheep. An angel of the Lord came to them, and a bright light surrounded them. They were terrified, but the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I'm not here to harm you, but to bring you good news, news of joy for the entire world. A child has been born in Bethlehem tonight, a child who will be a savior to you, who is the Messiah. This is how you will know him. You will find him wrapped in cloth, sleeping in a manger." Suddenly, many more angels appeared, and they praised God, singing, "Glory to God in the highest part of heaven, peace to all on earth who find favor with him." When the angels left, the shepherds said to each other, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this child." And they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger, just as the angel said.
Turned home by a different way.
one called the Word existed. This Word was with God, and the Word was God himself. In the beginning, the Word and God were one. Through him, everything came into being. Nothing came into being without him. In him was life, and he gave life to everything he made. His life was like a light shining in the darkness of human existence. But the darkness was so heavy that people were unable to see the light, even though it continued to shine despite the darkness. So God sent a man named John to tell the people about the light, that they might know about it and believe in it. John was not the light himself. He was sent to announce the light. The one perfect light that gives its light to everyone is coming into the world. When he came to the world he made himself, it did not recognize him. He came to his own people, the ones he made, and was not welcomed to them. But those who did welcome him into their lives became children of God like him. Even though they were not God's flesh and blood children, he welcomed them into his family. But Christ, who was with the Word, became flesh and blood like us and lived with us. We saw his light, the light of the Father, shining through the Son, showing us his grace and truth.
Remembering that you sent light into our world, we give thanks that we we never need to live in darkness. Remembering that you sent your Son as one of us, we give thanks that through him we have become your children. Remembering your great love and mercy, with the angels we too give thanks and praise. And now, may the light of the Word shine upon our path and guide our way. May the light watch over us and be a companion to us by night. May the light burn in our hearts and shine through our lives by day. And through our living, may we be a witness of that light to the world. Amen.